What happened to make it that happen?
Oh, I just think I ran into one of the girls, and it's just my shoulder freaked out. So, but it was fine after a while, and I caught my breath and got some water. So, okay.
But after that, range of motion was normal and everything?
I think I was just more scared of the sound and how it felt than anything. So,
Well, it had to be a relatively nice birthday to play the number 25 team in the nation and have individually one of your best games, you know, in an unlikely scenario for that to happen, given their size. Like, how did that, you know, how did you take that? How, and what was the experience like?
I will say playing UNLV is one of my favorite games of the year because it's just like they're so hyped in the conference. And don't get me wrong, they're really good players. And it's just like, I think next time we play them, we all believe in ourselves a little more, so we'll have a better shot. And it's just, I love playing them because they're good competition, and I like playing good competition. And like, for my 4 years here, I think it's been like my other past good, like high scoring game was against UNLV. So I just always have fun playing against them.
Now, given that 4 years of experience you've had and the perspective you've gained, like obviously you guys have reached a level where you can play essentially 500 ball against everybody else, but UNLV is still this on this perch. Do you see a path for the program to someday climb that?
Oh, you know, definitely.
And how would that happen?
I think our freshman class is one of the most talented, hardworking classes to have come through this program, and probably comparing to the 22er class when we had the most successful season here. They just work so well. They just are so adaptable, and they're really good listeners. And when you tell them something, they'll change immediately. I think if they just stay together and keep going, they'll have really good success in the coming years just playing with each other.
And did the team do anything to celebrate your birthday?
They all said happy birthday and everything. I don't think anyone really knew. I didn't. I'm becoming an old lady. 22 is not the funnest. I don't like it. Doesn't sound good.
But.
Yeah, just wait till you're our age. Enjoy it while you can. Happy birthday, Dasha. I just have one question. You know, it felt like today you were really trying to be, I mean, you had a tall task defensively on Desiree Young, and every night, you know, you're in a battle defensively, but you were really trying to be, it seemed to me at least, aggressive offensively, looking for your shot from the perimeter, posting up on the interior. Did you go into this game knowing you had to be good on both ends?
Honestly, yes, I did, because they're just such a high caliber of a team. They're good offense and defense, and I know Desiree Young, like, she's a beast, honestly. Like, if you don't make contact with her first, you're done. And I'm like, okay, if she's going to score on me, I'm going to score on her. And I'm like, that was kind of my mentality today. I'm like, well, I'm not going to let her have 26 points and me have my usual 3. So it's like I had to balance something over there, so.
How do you feel just about, I mean, this game last year, it was close to a 40-point game, whatever it was. How do you feel about how this one played out? Just being able to keep this game within 12, where there's some good moments you feel like this team, you know, kind of just displayed out there.
Oh, genuinely. I know there was a point, I think we were down 6, it was 5 or 6, and I'm like, we honestly could do it right now. And that just comes from our inexperience, I feel like, is just there's so many young players on the court at one time, and I had to tell them, like, you play to win, you don't just play to get better. You do play to get it better, let me not say, but you play, like, right now we're on the last half of our conference in our season, and it's just kind of like you have to play to win, and that has to be your mindset. And I realize I'm a senior, I don't have another year here, and so, like, every game I'm going into it, and I just want to win and be the most successful that I can be for me and the team, and just to have just success when we get to the tournament.
First, I want to hear your thoughts.
I thought this team took a big step forward, and I think that that's the best job. I mean, you're talking the youngest team in the conference against the most experienced team, least experienced team against the most experienced team in the conference. And I thought we came down very focused, very dialed into what we needed to do. And it you know, the first quarter was all even, and then it would only be like a 2 or 3 minute stretch in the second quarter, 2 or 3 minute stretch in the third quarter, 2 or 3. That was the difference in the game. And otherwise, it was a pretty, you know, sustained effort, and there would just be those little few minutes where we'd miss a couple shots, and then, you know, and they'd make them, and then that would be another 4 or 5 points, you know, tacked onto their lead. And so I think, and they made a lot of tough shots where I feel like, gosh, if we make everybody try to beat us with those shots, I'd be happy, you know. We did a pretty good job on the big kids. The only thing we just struggled, and you know we knew we would, is mitigating them on the offensive boards and just having the difference in second chance points. You know, was the difference in the game.
You know, in the time I've watched you, it's all about, you know, climbing to the next tier of competition, and you've basically reached to the point where you're a 500 team in conference, but UNLV is still at this stage above. Do you see enough talent now to where you can start to dream that you guys could be there?
Well, considering how many freshmen were out there doing those things, sure. And it's just, I don't know if we'll ever, you know, have that 6'3" type of player that can sort of do it all. It'd be nice. I think we have one almost that big who's promised to come next year. But I feel so good about our young players. I feel so good about just their mentality, the way they approach things. And that just speaks to what they're going to be capable of doing as they keep learning more and more and working on their skills and improving. And, you know, Milani Perry, they were all over her. And so I think the next thing for her to learn is how to make them pay for that, how to make them pay for putting two and three people on her. And she'll learn that. And then I thought that, you know, Alexis Cortez is just a impressive defensive player. She just affects what's going on out there. And to be able to play her on the perimeter is a huge advantage. But you know, again, you look out there, there were several times we had four freshmen on the floor, and I think their young players are quite good too. I'm certainly impressed with their depth, and that's part of what makes it so tough to beat them. You know, they were dragging. If that had been a 4-point game, 5-point game going into that fourth quarter or going down the stretch in that fourth quarter, we might have had a chance because they were really tired because we just made them work. We made them work. And we just have to keep building on that and what that effort and the way we, you know, played and stayed focused. I liked a lot of the shots we got. Maybe we just have to work on hitting a few more of them. Maybe we can if they're not 6'3" in front of us.
Any thoughts on, you know, Dasha being able to have this performance?
Best game she's played. And just to see her fight like that, and if she keeps, you know, can keep up that level of fight and can get us some buckets like that. I mean, we love having her out there because she talks, she's experienced, she's a really good leader on the court. And, you know, just and her defense, and just for that purpose alone, she deserves to be out there plenty. But when she can add some scoring too, wow, that's just icing. And so hopefully this will kind of build her confidence to keep growing her game.
Okay. And then update on Joe, where do things stand?
She at this point is should be able to play some minutes starting next week. And you know, we've been using her in practice on the scout team, and every time she goes up and down the floor, I go, "Oh, that's what we've been missing," because you know, nobody gets the ball to the right people at the right time like Joe does, and she's really good at that. And I think it'll just to have her available, and then it's something that has to build. We're not going to be able to play her significant minutes anytime soon, but just to be able to have her available will be really nice.
Because
of the process of bringing her back slowly, and primarily because your greatest chance of re-injury occurs because you get fatigued, and so we want to be sure she gets in game shape and we don't leave her out there any amount of minutes that could expose her.
Coach, both of you guys rely so much on your ability to turn the other team over, UNLV, and you know, you guys, both teams did a good job of taking care of the basketball. You turned them over four times the first quarter, and then they kind of settled in, and that wasn't really the case today for either of you. You guys did a great job taking care of the basketball. I think you only had maybe 10 or 11. When the game is being played that way and you're not able to do the things that you want to do in terms of points off turnovers, you still had quite a few. What is your team focusing on in the half court offensively, and what are the kind of the steps of growth that you're seeing?
Well, we're trying to, I mean, you're you're accurate. It's really important to us to turn people over because it's a significant percentage of our scoring. And, you know, we had a tough time getting Wyoming to turn the ball over and had a tough time scoring as a result. But I think that we've tried very hard to just have them have more versatility in what they're doing in that half court with that motion. Like you saw how many times we threw it inside and how many times we would curl or we would drive on the catch, and we've just been building a lot on the attack aspects of the offense and not having it just be in fact I thought one of our weakest stretches was when we were, you know, shooting those threes one right after the other in that second quarter, and that really cost us. And we're gonna hit some, but we cannot make a diet of the 3-point shot. And so we just have to continue to work on our ability to attack off of that offense. And I think we've taken some major strides on that.
One more. I want to talk about the elephant in the room, sort of. Madison Smith was taken out of the starting lineup. I think it was at Nevada, if I'm reading my stuff right. Mm-hmm. Reasons for that, and maybe she's kind of in a slump, it seems, to now. What can you tell us about that situation?
Well, I love Madison Smith, and I know what she's capable of doing. And I believe that sometimes you just need to step away a little bit. We went through a stretch like this with Riley Snyder a few years ago, and you need to take a little step away and kind of, you know, get your mojo back a little bit. She's going to be an integral part of everything that we're doing. It was essentially a case of saying, you know, gosh, we need more defense, we need more offense. So I went and said, here's the person on the bench that provides the most offense, here's the person on the bench that provides the most defense, let's put them in the lineup and see what happens. But Madison, I'm not worried about Madison. She's going to get it figured out.